I got a tip last night from my fence. Heartless Perry. A nobleman named Lord Julian had some sort of quarrel and showed up at a local inn well after nightfall and in a foul mood. He's carrying a velvet bag about the size of a man's fist, and it never leaves his sight. Sounds likely to be valuable, but I'll know for sure when I steal it from him. Perry sent over a floor plan of the place, the Blue Heron Inn. Finding his lordship won't be hard. His room number will be in the guest register, if I can get to the front desk to read it. The inn will have guards, but not as many as a private estate. That should make things easy, which is one of the reasons I'm willing to try it without knowing for sure what the take will be. Lord Julian is so protective of that bag. There's got to be something of value in it.
Come on! Barely felt that!
I'll show you, Taffer!
Anybody! Little help? Feel!
Tavern while I'm stuck here.
Lord Julian. Wouldn't do to have anyone think he was just Julian.
Are we fighting?
His lordship has gone for a walk. Can't have gone far.
Thank you.
card and I'll get it.
Five picked men.
My lord.
Five picked men with me, and we cut our way through.
He's your cousin, my lord.
I won the bet. My shaft was closer by a thumb's width. The bloodline opal should rightfully be mine.
If I may, my lord, I can help you. I know the castle.
Well, you're a cook. What could you know?
Every evening after sunset, the supply wagon comes through that gate and into the courtyard. And no one looks twice. Arrange for your men to be inside one evening.
And then we cut our way through. Five good men against 20. And my accursed cousin.
My lord, listen. There is a passage leading to the castle from the courtyard. I can open it for you when you give me the signal. The torch in the lion's head sconce. You must put it out.
The lion's head torch.
Yes.
And when I reach the vault and hold the bloodline opal, I will take my... place as head of the family. The Lady Elizabeth will be...
Didn't see anything!
The lion's head torch.
Yes.
And when I reach the vault and hold the bloodline opal, I will take my place as head of the family. The Lady Elizabeth will be waiting. Even now, she'll be flattering him, giving me time to return.
Only the medallion is the only key, my lord. You must keep hold of it.
You forget Lord Ember has another. I hear he guards it with his life.
My lord, I wish only for peace in the household.
The opal is mine. I won that bet, Morris. I won it. My pouch. It's gone. Stolen. Who dares? I will have your head for this. Guards! Guards! Gah! I have to put my foot down. Come out this instant.
The bag feels heavy. There's something metal inside.
Not crazy. It'll just take a second to look around, okay?
What? Something... over there?
After this, I'll definitely need an extra pill or two.
A guard's life, protecting people. Places. Thought it would be more, I don't know, exciting.
Close one, but I've still got the goods.
Sometimes your ears play tricks on you.
Nothing like mixing in society, especially if it comes with good loot. The velvet bag turned out to hold a bronze medallion stamped with a griffin. Valuable enough, but more interesting was the conversation I overheard between Lord Julian and the cook. Especially the part about a huge opal and a conspiracy for stealing it. I'd hate to have anyone but me get a stone like that. But I need a better idea where to start looking. If I show the medallion to my fence, I'm sure he'll know more. Heartless Perry always does. My fence take a look at Lord Julian's medallion. Perry says the crest belongs to the Rutherfords, one of the oldest so-called great families, with a castle in South Quarter and a street named after them. They've got a lot of wealth and a nasty reputation for turning on each other. Based on that conversation I overheard, Julian is definitely carrying on the family tradition. Lord Ember, Julian's cousin, currently resides in the castle, and Julian wants revenge. Julian had a good plan. Hide inside a supply cart and ride in after dark, then signal the cook to open the side door by putting out the lion's head torch in the courtyard. A good enough plan for me to use myself. That bloodline opal sounds valuable, and it's better off with me than sitting around in their vault. But I can't get lazy. Ember will have his personal guard, and doubtless a few other family tricks in store for anyone who comes after the opal.
Thank you.
There's the torch.
How's it going?
Now to give the signal.
Quiet tonight.
It's the rain earlier. Everyone's gone in. Black as pitch out here.
They doubled the watch.
This castle's as old as South Quarter. See the way the stone is? Pulled off an army. Probably had...
You really think so?
Who knows? It's an old part of town. Streets are all different here, not like Aldale or Stone Market.
What are you...
Who turned that off?
It's out.
Is this a joke?
I hope that cook is as good as his word.
Where was that? Nothing. Can't run off at every...
Funny noise for this time of night. Nope. Quiet night after all. Salt pork. Disgusting. Yes, my lord. No, my lord. I would never think that, my lord. Ah! I ought to let them know what's happening here.
Probably nothing, but just in case. Probably just a rat scurrying about. I shouldn't have bothered.
Not much choice, though, for a guy like me.
What the? Someone sneaking around over there? Who are you? What you hiding for? Don't worry. I'm not dangerous, whoever you are. What are you playing at? I better tell someone about- What are you playing at?
Lady Elizabeth is a proper lady. She attended Lady Pollock's school for young ladies, and she can write in both ancient Brilliant and modern Prinkish.
Well, I guess that's something.
Your Lord Ember's knowledge of the world is limited to the names of his ancestors and equine diseases of the mouth.
I don't like the way she looks at me, like I've been sneaking about or something.
Well, you are a bit unkempt.
It's them stairs. She has me up there 5 times a night, changing the torches.
Oh, indeed. I shall inform the lady of your displeasure.
Don't you dare.
Wake up there, imbecile.
Yes, your lordship. If I hadn't taken an oath.
Wake up there, imbecile.
Yes, sir. I hope Julian comes back soon.
Parola!
Now I saw that. What's going on? There, I...
Wake up there, imbecile.
Yes, sir. I hope Julian comes back soon.
I beg your pardon.
Just then.
Turn that back on.
See anything? Some bloody fool.
If anyone will pay more for a matched set.
Spooked at nothing. Maybe my relief will come soon.
Thank you.
some kind of... What's that racket? Now I see you. You'll have to hit harder. Kidding me? Oh. There you are. Drop your weapon.
Poisons. Better make sure I wash my hands when I get out of here. Rutherford family vault. That opal is as good as mine.